Go Fetch Gang, Go Fetch Family, welcome back, welcome back. It's your man's Ride the Dime. And in this video, I'm gonna give y'all 7 reasons as to why being a dog breeder is just really not even worth it. Let's get straight into it. To choose it, love or never, without a rubber. Never in the sheets, like it on top of the cover. Money on the dresser, drive a compressor. Top notch, get the most, not the lesser. Trash like the for 40. So let's just get straight into it. First things first, being a breeder is expensive. I don't care what the hell dog you got, from Dalmatians to German Shepherds to Bullies. I can speak for Bullies. Being a bully breeder is expensive. I made a video a couple of weeks ago talking about why the American bully is so expensive. So that kind of covers most of what I'm about to say right now. But I mean, I'll give you a recap. Paying for the dog, feeding the dog, before the dog can produce puppies, if you have a girl, you know you're gonna have to take care of this dog for at least 16 to 18 months before you know it's even healthy for them to have puppies. You know what I'm saying? Vet bills, you know, and all of that comes to be thousands of dollars, you know, stud fees. So it's just like, it's pricey. It's one pricey as occupation. And it takes money to make money, for sure. And in this occupation, that holds true. There's no way you can think to invest a couple of $100 and think to make thousands back. You have to invest thousands for you to get thousands. And really, you just may be breaking even, or, you know, come out just a little bit on top. So it's a very, very expensive occupation. And, you know, a lot of people have to work to support this occupation, you know? So, and that's what most hustles, that's what most gigs, that's what most businesses, but I can attest firsthand, this is pricey. And I'll give you a deeper breakdown if you like me to. Hit me in the comment section. I'll give you a whole deeper breakdown. Or, like I said, you can watch my previous video as to why bullies are so expensive, and then I'll cover that. Two, I got my little notepad right here. You know, don't judge me. Two, this could be a shady game, baby. You know, I've had dogs stolen from me. I've had business gone sour. It's just really a lot of things that could go left. People lie a lot. People hang paperwork. I'll talk about that in a whole nother video. And people will sell you something you did not pay for, you know? When I get my studs, when I do my stud fees, I have to see the dog. I prefer going to the vet, because if I'm giving you money, I need to see the whole process, and I need to ensure I'm getting what I paid for. Because I can give you a couple thousand dollars, never see you, and you send me horse sperm, cow sperm, you know what I'm saying? That never happened to me because I'm so diligent with that process, but I'm sure it has. I have clients come to me telling me like, yeah, man, you know, I'm gonna rock with you next time. I'm gonna purchase a dog from you. I would have got one this litter, but I just got scammed for $2,500, you know? So, you know, it's scammers, it's people that do shady business. I did business with this one individual, and he got mad at me. Check this. He got mad at me because I didn't want to participate with the scam. I mean, that don't even make sense. Like, you know, if you want to risk your whole brand, your whole everything you done built up for a quick dollar, and potentially somebody you forever having to look over your back, go ahead and do it. But you can't get mad because I ain't want to do it. But that's something that I've dealt with. Like I said, I have gotten dogs stolen from me. You know, went to work one day, I come back, somebody done clipped my fence. And this is like, is it ever that deep? But it is. It is. So It's a real shady business. It can be shady. And it all depends on your demographic, who you're dealing with, what you do. But, I mean, it's shady stuff can happen at any level, no matter who you're dealing with. So you got to pick who you're dealing with accordingly. I can't stress that enough. You know, so that's two. It's expensive. Two, it can be shady. Three, it's a saturated market. It's a saturated market, especially where I'm from. I'm from Detroit, ladies and gentlemen. Everybody and their auntie want to breed bullies, you know, and I love them. And people who get their dog from me, oh, I'm going to give you all the information that I got, because, you know, it's a pay to play thing. And if you purchase a dog from me, you paid. So now we can play. You feel me? But it is so saturated. You know, I'm going to tell you another story. My very first litter, my very, very first litter, it was BB and Crixus. I love them to this day. Some of the foundations, I still got some of their dogs to this day. I love them, love them, love them. I had several puppies come out of this litter. And, you know, I was lowballing myself, but I was still trying to get what they was worth. You know, so I decided to sell these dogs for about like $1,100, which at the time was a steal. And it was maybe kind of dumb on my end, but this was my breakout litter, you know? So there's no way I can charge the same thing a Bossy Kennel or a Blueberry Kennel. Shout out to Blueberry, I rocks with them heavy. There's no way I could charge their prices with me just starting my whole kennel breed. So I had this gentleman that stayed, you know, in my neighborhood. He came up to me. I told him the price of the dog, and he laughed at me. You know, he was just like, why would I pay $1,100 for this dog right here when your neighbor down the street is only charging about $200, $250 for the best one? And I was just like, wow. You know, at the time, like I said, I was a novice at the time. At the time, I was just looking at him like, well, bro, I don't know what you want me to say to you, because this is what I need for these dogs. So I'm saying that, I mentioned that story to say, it's just a saturated market. It's an extremely saturated market. There's always somebody that's willing to sell a dog cheaper than what you're willing to sell it for. You know, I see people all the time on Facebook forums or whatever. Hey, looking for a dog for $1,200. And it's just like, I'm no longer in the $1,200 range, you know. But, you know, if there's people selling a similar breed, a dog or a similar dog to what I have for $1,200, that's putting a strain on the market. That's it. It makes selling dogs a hassle. Because the last thing a breeder, a legit breeder, want to hear is that Pookie and them around the street is selling a similar looking dog for only $300. You know? So it's an extremely saturated market, and it can be complicated. It can be so complicated. I know another gentleman, and I'm actually cool with him. I ain't got no malice with him or whatnot. Their very first breeding, they wanted $8,000 for these puppies. And it's like, you don't have the right credentials. You don't have productions. Can nobody pull up an old dog, or can nobody vouch for you saying that your dogs is healthy and they live past the age of two? You know? But it blew my mind that he was trying to sell these dogs for $8,000 and they feeding me the wedding again. Threw me off. But that's something that I also have to deal with it being a saturated market. Is people selling their dogs for three times the amount that I'm selling it, and three times lower than what I'm selling it. So it's a hassle. It's a hassle. You have to stand out. You have to do something with your program, with your kennel, for you to stand out. And boy, it is hard. I'm gonna be the first to tell you that it is hard, but if you dedicate it, it can happen for you. I'm the living testament to that. You know what I'm saying? You feel me? Three, saturated market. Four, you always have to invest. You always have to invest. So with the bully game, you know, when you get money from selling puppies, some people do the stud thing. I like to produce puppies. That's my thing. I love making it happen. I love making the breed better. So, you know, when I do get my revenue in, most of the time, I have to put that right back into the business. One of the biggest investments that I've recently had to make was a privacy fence. I have a pretty nice sized backyard, so I had to wrap the privacy fence all around my yard to A, prevent from somebody stealing my dogs again, B, me having the security knowing that my dogs are not leaving my backyard, and that was thousands of dollars. And I was just like, man, you know, the profits that I just received, I had to put back into the business. So it's not like I even receive the money and go to Punta Cana, you know, go to Colombia, anything like that. No, we putting this right back in the business. So it takes money to make money. And then the money you make, you got to reinvest. And like I said, that's what most businesses, you know, at least if you want them to thrive. But I'm just telling you, in a bully game, don't think that you're just going to get this money and then, yeah, I just got all this and I'm not, you know, I can just do this with this. No, you got to put a great portion back into the business so it can be more efficient, so it can be less of a headache. You know, it's just part of the game. Simple as that. Number five is, being a bully breeder is a long-term game, and it don't come fast whatsoever. You know, from you getting the dog and raising the dog. So I often talk about having female dogs because I have a lot of female dogs. I love my girl dogs. My girl dogs love me, but I also love my boy dogs for sure. I don't know if y'all heard that. Rory just pooted, and she trifling, man. She trifling. Let's say if you have a boy dog, you know, most of the time it takes boy dogs about two and a half years for them to mature. And, you know, sometimes if the dog is just that amazing, you could definitely start making money off of him even sooner than the 2 years, you know, sooner than the 1 year mark if he's just that special. But on average, it takes about 2+ years for the male dog to be fully grown to the point where people see him and be like, okay, I want to use him. You know what I'm saying? But that's 2 years in. You know what I'm saying? You have to feed him for 2 years. Baby, you got to calm down. You got to calm down. You got to feed him for 2 years. You got to take him to the vet for 2 years. He's going to chew up your shoes. He's going to chew up your couch. You know, that's something else that nobody really mentions that much. It's okay. Me personally, I don't like to just leave my dogs locked up. So, you know, I try to have them free roam. But with the free roam, they're going to get into some stuff. The expensive stuff. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, it's just really a long-term game. Really a long-term game. Even with the girls and the puppies or whatnot, I mean, with me, that's a 6-month process. You know, you got to find the stud. I like to find the stud a couple of months beforehand. Then you got to inseminate the girl. The girl is pregnant for 2 months. Boom, she had a puppy. It's cool. Now you got to keep the puppies for 2 months. So, excuse me, ladies and gentlemen. So cool out, mama. So that's a 6-month process. 6 months. It is not a quick game. You're not going to get your money back immediately. It's going to take years, typically, for you to recoup your investment. Your investment. Not for you to make money. Your investment. You dig what I'm saying? So you got to be mindful of that. You digs? Another thing is death. Death and being a breeder. This is just with any breeder. Death, you're going to experience death. You're going to experience life. You're going to experience death. recently, well, I ain't gonna say too recently, but I've experienced a dog dying in my hand, like an actual puppy taking their last breaths in my hand, you know? And, you know, some people, I met some gentlemen, you know, they like, oh, you know, it's just part of the game. It is what it is. It's whatever. But with me, that really take a toll on me because I really pour everything I got into my dog. I pour everything I got into my puppy. So if I lose one, I really feel like I lose a family member, you know? And that wasn't the first time I dealt with death regarding puppies. Sometimes the mama squish them, you know? And it's not necessarily the mom's fault, you know, especially if she have an abundance of puppies. Sometimes she's not going to realize that she's laying on one if she has 9 puppies in front of her, you know? That's a major loss. That's a major loss emotionally for me and financially as well, because this dog is what I went through this whole process for. So when you lose one, I lose a piece of me and I lose a part of my financial investment. And that's just me speaking as a businessman. But death is something you have to deal with. You have to deal with, you know? So it takes a lot out of you. It takes a whole lot out of you. Along with the puppies, you gotta really put your time in with them, or the death can be your fault. You know? So I'm gonna make a whole nother video about that as well. Death with being a breeder. Horrible. Absolutely horrible. I don't wish that on my worst enemy, you know? But it happens in the business, and you just gotta know how to keep things flowing, you know? Last but not least, just unexpected costs and miscellaneous things happen, you know? Last year, 2 of my dogs ran away. And that's why I ended up putting up the privacy fence, because it's just like, wow, man, I did not expect that. I did not expect that. And these are some dogs that I've groomed for over 2-3 years, you know? I finally got the boy to the standard that I want. I finally had some people willing to lock in with him. And as soon as the ball got to rolling, he ran away. Really was my fault. You know, it wasn't my fault, but I take accountability for that. But that is something that's just unexpected. What else is just pretty much unexpected? My brother, he got some bullies as well. He typically, you know, you can feed dogs bones, but his particular dog was not digesting the bones properly. He had to go spend $1,500 just so his dog can take a poop. So the vet can go in, do whatever he do with the intestines so his dog can take a poop. And now he's on like medicated food. You know, extra vitamins and all of that. So all of that plays a role into being a breeder, you know? And everything that I mentioned is really, really serious. And you gotta really persevere to make things happen. You have to. It's a necessity. It's mandatory. So let's go over these numbers again. 1 is expensive. Expensive as hell. And don't let nobody tell you otherwise, because I'm telling you right here, right now, it's expensive as hell. You dig? 2, it can be shady. 3, it's a saturated market. It's a saturated market. It's a saturated market. So in order for you to be great, you got to be different. And a lot of people can't be different, unfortunately. 4, you always got to invest. As soon as you get money, you got to put it right back in. As soon as you get it, you got to put it right back in. And let's not get it twisted. You know, if done properly, if done right, and it's normally take a couple of years for you to get the process down right, you can then start making money and be profitable off of it. But, you know, if you half-ass it, if you only come at 50%, that's what you're going to get, 50% back. So you get what you put into it, but it is a saturated market and you always got to invest. Long-term game. This is not cryptocurrency. This is not Dogecoin, where you put something in for a couple weeks, 3 weeks, a month, 2 months, maybe even 3 months, and your money quadruple. Nope. These are living things that you have to take care of. I'm gonna say that one more time. These are living things that you have to take care of every day, every single day. You know, picking up poop, feeding them. I just bought some dog food and I was just like, wow, man, how much money have I spent on dog food within the past month? You know, and I'm not gonna tell you, but I'm gonna let you know, it's a lot. It's a whole lot. You did? Death and puppies, just cover that, and unexpected costs. So, I mean, if you're not discouraged by the seven things I've listed, and I'm sure that I can come up with another seven things as well. If you're not discouraged by that, hell, I say go for it. I say go for it because I'm not discouraged by the seven things that I've listed. I've been affected by it. I have received the short end of the stick sometimes, but if you got the heart for it, and if you can really, really persevere, it can be rewarding for you. So with that being said, this is your man's Ride to Dime. Follow my business page on Instagram at GoFetch Kennels. Like, subscribe, hit the notification bell, drop a comment down below, and I'm gonna be back at y'all with another video, baby. You already know how it go. Peace.